Welcome to one of the most ambitious zombies videos I've ever made. Over the next half an hour, I'm going to be taking on every single boss fight in Treyarch Zombies history. That means completing every Easter egg that's ever had a boss fight and completing it in this video. And with Cold War Zombies right around the corner, I thought it'd be perfect to look over at the bosses we've taken down to prepare us for the madness that's coming. Now, I know this sounds ridiculous, but this video took me nearly a whole year to make. So if you want to spare 1 second to leave a like if you enjoy this video at any point, that would be really nice. And since I started filming this video so long ago, I've been on a big weight loss journey, and you can physically see the appearance of my face change throughout this video. So if boss fights weren't enough, you actually see me get more good looking as the video goes on. But that's just my opinion. Big shout out to Elgato and G4 for sponsoring the channel. If you want to check either of them out, I've got links in the description, and be sure to use code Dalek at checkout. But enough with the shameless plugs, let's begin our boss fight journey.
Ladies and gentlemen, the best zombies map ever in my opinion, or at least one of the greatest, Der Eisendrache. Let's start up the boss fight, and oh man, I'm so excited for this because this just brings so many memories back from the days when this was a brand new map, and this was the very first boss fight in Call of Duty Zombies history for Treyarch. A fully amazing boss fight that actually has some really cool mechanics, and if you're not careful, it has that wipe mechanic that completely took us by surprise all the way back in the day. I remember it was just unbelievable. So, of course, I don't even need to explain this boss fight to you guys. You will know exactly how this works and what to do. There we go. I was waiting for the golden moment. I'm going to go ahead and plant my Ragnaroks down. Find this lovely keeper just facing us. I'm going to get my charge shot ready. I could chuck a monkey, but I'm just not going to. And we're just going to go absolutely ham sandwich on him. And there we go. My man is already done. Now, it does help so much to have the plunger when you're doing this boss fight. Definitely not needed. But oh man, it's so satisfying when you get to use that thing. And here we go. Some unwanted visitors right here, right now. The Panzer Soldats. Just gonna go straight ahead and ruin this guy's life. And boom, there we go. Get to use the plunger in all its glory. Oh, I love it. And just like that, we're done. Whoever Treyarch invented that plunger, you are an absolute legend. Because that thing saves lives. It really does. Now, I need to get these charged back up. I killed them far too quickly for my own good. Now, it is important as well to always be going around in an anti-clockwise formation. Or maybe you can go clockwise if you want. And yes, these are the dogs that I needed, man. These are the dogs I needed because they're going to charge my special weapon. There we go. That is the ticket, baby. Otherwise, we would have had to have gone one sort of wave without getting damage into the boss. But we are cruising through this. Right, there we go. There's our shot. And boom. There we go. Is that enough for him? Yes, it is. There we go. Rags only just finished as well. So we'll pick those up. And I'm actually going to wait on that max ammo. We're not going to grab it straight away. All right, let's chuck our monkey. Let's chuck another one. I'm feeling generous. There we go. Oh my god, that is a close panzer. You've got to be careful because sometimes their flame can just wreck you. And so can those grenades. Oh, that was close. Those little grenades are just so annoying. We'll grab that. Bop, you're gone. And I'm pretty sure that's it. Yep, we are done. I'm going to chuck a monkey, because why not? And we got dogs as well, just to finish filling up this lovely meter of ours. Oh, man, this has been a perfect run. I'm going to chuck one more. There we go. Let's get that down. Boom, get the rags down, and the last and final time. This has been such a good run, but I mean, after playing Der Eisendrache, one of the greatest maps ever, so many times over, I think it'd be impossible for you to not be able to do this on your first attempt. But there we go. Boom, panzer down. That's what we like to see. Skelly boy, can you not? All right, let's grab that summoning key. I'm ready, baby, I'm ready. Easily one of the best Easter eggs in Call of Duty Zombies, my absolute favorite, and I just can't get enough of these elemental bows. I love them. But anyway, you guys have seen this cutscene a billion times over. Let's jump over to Zetsubou no Shima.
You what, mate?
I'm coming.
I'm on the way down.
Okay, we're here.
You what? You just left Turbo.
I'm here.
You left Turbo. This easy. Is it pulled you in?
I'm coming down. Oh. I'm coming down either way, so. Oh, no, I'm here. Oh,
nice. That's good.
I feel violated. They just touched me and dragged me.
Maybe, you know.
I'm so down for DE after this.
I mean, DE is so easy.
You want to run a DE real quick after this?
Yeah, 100%. It's like less than an hour and then like,
oh,
door.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, my mask is nearly broke. Oh, that's not good.
Easy. I think if your mask breaks down here, you don't die instantly like you do if you come down here without one.
Yeah. Oh, my gas mask broke. Am I going to die in here?
Nah, mine's broke too.
Yeah, mine's
broke. We broke boys together.
However, I'm not coughing as much, so I think I'm healed by all this.
Yo, COVID? Yeah, I'm not catching the Rona from Takio. No, yeah, thank you.
One more to go.
One more away.
One more and you're stinking bad.
And then the Takio cutscene begins. Possibly my best one, you know, best cutscene in BO3.
Yeah. Yeah, I'd say it. It's most emotional cutscene. Actually, no, it's tied. Tied with blood.
This is kind of blood.
But like, I mean, the most emotional.
Yeah, but I think the Rising Drax is like the first big end cutscene, and the way like Dempsey was just acting, I think that always seems like the nostalgia factor. I think that like,
it just hits you. All right, come on, Takio. Let's free ya.
Come on, dude. Is this time or kill based? I've played this map a billion times, and I still don't know for sure.
I don't know. So you don't have to kill anything.
No, you don't have to kill anything at all.
I thought it was the more you killed, the faster.
No, just complete timer based.
I've been lied to.
Dude, this
is this
like
it?
This is like a
yes!
Boss fight. GG's!
Well, Zetsubou was actually not as bad as I thought it was going to be. We absolutely destroyed that Easter egg.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Gorod Krovi boss fight. I absolutely love this. Probably one of the most iconic, historic ones ever. Before we get to you, Nikolai, we got to take out the dragon. And oh my god, I can't wait for that. Who remembers just how iconic this was? All right, here we go. Dragon's weak. Let's go, let's go. Let's get his weak spot. And I love the Ray Gun Mark III. In this map, it is just too good against absolutely everything. Who remembers running around the map, having to just bring your shield up all the time when you're in the fire? Oh, and you got all of these bosses as well. Oh, Gorod Krovi, so good, man. I'm trying to juggle like a billion zombies that are trying to get me whilst also trying to hit that dragon. Let's take care of these manglers. One last weak spot for the dragon. Let's get it. And the thing is, it's so easy to hit the dragon too. Like, there we go with the ray gun. It's so simple, already done. That's one half of it done, and it just looks so good. Even this in-game cutscene to me was so cool back in the day. I'm sure you guys still agree. But this is where the real fun begins, okay? And let's see how quickly we can take him down. I've not done this in a hot minute, so we could smash it, or it could be the worst thing you've ever seen. Please, can it be the first option? So all you gotta do is shoot these front bits here. The bits on the top that are shooting out the wraps. Let's try and get rid of them as fast as we can, please. There we go. I think that's good. And now just the core at the bottom. And there we go. There's all she wrote. Gorod Krovi done. And if you're doing this on console, no crashes. There you go. That was so damn quick. I'm actually quite astonished. But let's move on to the finale of Black Ops 3, which is Revelation. Let's do this. Revelations boss fight. I am so ready and so not ready at the same time. Oh my god. So this, back in the day, like, this room is just gorgeous to look at. You can't deny that this room is absolutely beautiful. I love it still. It's sending chills down my spine, especially since I've not played this in so long. It feels good. But Pans, you need to get away. You need to get away right now. So what we need to do is we need to fill up the summoning key right here with souls until it's full, to the point where, you know, we can just go ahead and throw it up to our good old friend. Boom, Thunder Gun just took that thing down. Are we good to go? We have enough souls. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick up the summoning key. I'm going to throw it in, and then we're instantly little Arnie-ing it. And I need, there we go, my dire wolf. We just need to spray the heck out of this. Can we get this first time? Because this is not easy, just because it keeps darting around everywhere. Is that it? Yes! Oh my god! First attempt, are you crazy? That's how quickly you can defeat the Revelations boss fight. Wow. There we go, in literally no time at all, you completed Revelations. If you haven't already, click the like button for that. please go ahead and do so. Wow, and then of course, the absolute legendary ending, which obviously a big troll, and had to wait 3 years to see what happened next. But now that we've done that, it's time to shift gears and move on to Black Ops 4. Ladies and gentlemen, Voyage of Despair. Hold X to proceed, you won't come back from this. One of the craziest boss fights in all of Zombies history, in my opinion. And we start it off by collecting the Sentinel artifact. And this is quite an eerie atmosphere to be in when it comes to, like, you'll never see this spot again in this map. We've never seen anything quite like it, but we're going to activate it, and here we go. I'm very nervous about this one, so please wish me luck in the comments. Oh, we're starting back here, and look at that, the iceberg's rising out the ground. Fun fact, we have a massive eye that's about to come out this. And in this, I'm playing with my good friend XMJakey. I'm sure most of you who watch my videos and streams remembers, and he's helping me out on this one. There he is. Coming out of the iceberg. Let's focus on killing all of these zombies. Oh my god, there he is. So what makes this boss fight so special and so different compared to the other boss fights in Call of Duty Zombies is that it has tons of phases. It has like 5 phases. I don't think any boss fight has ever had that much. Gorod has like 2. If there's one thing that I hope Treyarch brings in Black Ops 5, or even, I don't know if this will even happen in DLC 4, but just bring back the Helion. Or just a rocket launcher that's just as powerful, because that thing is insane. Nice. Oh, did we lose it? Did we lose it? No, no, no. Oh, go on, quick. Oh my God. Have you never seen someone flail so hard to get a max ammo in your life? Where's the best place to camp in this one? Oh, it's up here, isn't it? Oh yeah, there's a freezing area. So if you walk into it, you actually freeze. Funny that, right? But what makes it even funnier is my wonder weapon has a freeze effect, which I forgot how good it was. May also add, I've only done this Easter egg once, ever. I've only completed it once. So if we do this, I will genuinely be so happy. I definitely think Voyage of Despair, like now I'm playing it, I'm actually really enjoying it. I do think it's gotten a lot of slack. It's definitely not your normal Zombies map, but you can definitely appreciate just how much effort went into it. Oh, we just bopped up. Okay, calm down, boy.
Nah, I'm out of here.
Hey, there we go, finally. Third wave, guys. So if I remember correctly, it's, oh. You have to hide in one of these rooms. Which room are you hiding in? Oh, he's right. It's right in front of me.
Oh, he's doing the other aisle.
Yeah, I think we got that. I think he's only got like a little bit more damage. Boss fight's so intense. Yep, I'm shooting him now. Oh, that was a lot of damage. I'm gonna chuck one more because we've got a stoker in now. Surely his eye's got to be this way now. Yep, got him. I'm on this side. I'm on the side. Come on. There we go. We got it. We got it. We got it. We got it. Phase 4. I really like this phase. I don't know why.
This one was easy. Yeah. You got a lot of room to move about.
So remember, that Helion salvo is just disgusting.
Oh,
go,
nope.
Go, 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 go. Oh my God. Is that already? Wow. Literally within 5 seconds of being on the map, boom, already massive damage. That rocket launcher is just insane. All right, here we go. There it is. All right. This is it, ladies and gentlemen. The moment you've all been waiting for. You grab the max and there we go. This is it, ladies and gentlemen. This is life or death now. So he's going to be lasering us around, but it's when he does the most damage. Got to chuck the humunk and just be ready. Okay, I'm just hella nervous, man. I'm sure we got enough firepower to do it. Okay, he's off to... He's right in front of...
Oh my God, he keeps moving, man.
I'm spraying him. I think that might have done it. I'm just constantly keeping watch. He's off to the other side of the ship now.
Yeah.
Nice. All right, this could be it. Yeah, this is it. I'm chucking a humunk.
I've already got one down.
Oh, nice. Doesn't matter. Just keep shooting him. That was it. Woo! Okay. 1 of 3. We're making this look easy. Trust me, it's not. We got Blightfathers in now. How about I just deal with all the nasties? You just focus on shooting him.
Yep.
Okay, he's going. Oh, that's close to me. Oh, that laser was close. When we're shooting him, when he's doing his wipe for the second time, you chuck a humunk, unless you've got none left. Okay, go, 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 go. All right, this is it. I'm chucking one. Just keep going.
I have to collect that.
That's fine. Okay, that's phase two done. Oh my god, that was so scary. All right, last phase. We got this. Helion salvo, boys. Okay, yes, Jakey's got him. I think yes, he has. All right, two more left. The Helion salvo. Thank you, Treyarch. Okay, he's in the middle. I'm shooting him, I'm shooting him.
Whoa.
Okay, that's it. He's gonna have one more. He's gonna move one more time. One more time, and then that's it. The last wipe. And I'll chuck a Hmunk, so you can just focus on just shooting him. Oh, he froze me. But I still got my Hmunk. Yep. Okay, here we go, here we go. Here we go. Oh my god, and this lasts for so long as well. Yo, we done it. Yes. Voyage of Despair done. Oh my freaking god. Yo. That's it. We also got the Dark Ops challenge for zero downs. Considering Voyage of Despair is not easy. Two players, zero downs. Man, that's the first time we've ever actually done the Easter egg. We've attempted it so many times, always failed. Now on to the next map. So here we are on 9, ladies and gentlemen, the best map on Black Ops 4 Zombies, and we are about to fight some mutant elephants. I cannot wait. This is like one of my favorite maps ever. Okay, so here we go. Hold square, travel to the boss arena. You will not return. I have not done this in a hot minute. I am so excited. Again, I'm joined here by XM Jakey, but you won't be able to hear him in this because it's gotta be quiet, okay? I don't think there was anything better than the first reaction of seeing this. Just this entire boss arena, it's insane. And just how much goes into it. Like, we got all these gladiators first, then we got tigers, and then you got the big boy himself. Yeah, the amount of max ammo you get during this boss fight is probably the world record in any zombies map. Also, can we please appreciate the free perk that I got earlier? Death perception. Really good. Oh, here we go. The guardian approaches. There he is. Okay, so my box luck was awful, so I couldn't get the Helion to save my life. But Jakey does have it, so I'm going to help you out. I'm just going to chuck her monks, and you go for it. Luckily, I've got the Hades, which is arguably one of the other better guns in the game. Oh my god, that was so quick. It's been, what, 10 seconds? Right, I'm going to chuck another her monk. This boy looks angry. He's ready to storm. Wait, what? Is he already dead? Oh my god. It's already dead. Okay, two clips of ammo. That's all it took him. All right, please try out. Put the Helion salvo in the next game. This is like, it's a timeless, like it's just an iconic part of zombies now. Look at you, if you look at him with your homunculus just rolling around in your hands. Oh, here he is. Boy number two. I'm gonna let you do the honors, Jakey. I also love as well, you have the boys that sit on top of the elephant. Oh. The boys on top of the elephant just throwing like arrows at you. How quick are we gonna do it this time? Is this a world record? Gotta shoot its heart. I mean, this is gonna be dead any moment. It's already dead. No. Yeah, it's dead. Oh, can we get a 9.2? Does that even make sense? A 9.5? An IX? II? Oh man, I've never seen this cutscene before in like 4K PC quality with all the textures turned up. It's beautiful, but we need to move on to the next map, my friends. So let's do it. Hell yes, boss fight time. Here we go, the boss fight, Blood of the Dead. Arguably one of the coolest boss fights in BO4.
Yeah, I agreed.
And look, there's a gigantic Brutus. The disrespect. Trying to drain his energy. Whoa, there he goes.
Let's go. You're gonna have a really cool time, Adrian.
I'm so hyped, dude. So hyped. So here we go. Boom, we activate that. And the big reveal. It was all just a circuit. The four-ring sequence. Oh my god, I've never seen the door animation like that before. That was sick. Here we go. There we go. Let's do it. Look at this man. He is mad right now. Also, I have no Blundergat ammo, so this is great. I'll just get a few souls with a... Have I got two? Yeah, I got two. So you might have to carry killing these dudes.
It's all good.
Oh, that was easy. That was a direct impact then. Sick.
Nice.
I'll say this boss fight is pretty cool. The
Very
stuff
cool.
that happens in it is awesome. But I just wish there was a bit more of an actual boss.
Yeah, I know,
to
right?
fight.
It should have been like a huge Brutus in outside the map where you've got to like pinpoint areas of his body for certain attacks and stuff.
Yeah.
Just an absolutely monstrous Brutus outside.
Okay, here we go.
Can we just delete this guy, please?
Is it time to shock the middle?
No, not yet.
Oh yeah, oh, we need him to spawn first. There we go. Oh, max ammos.
Okay, shot the middle, wait for it. Countdown, three.
Three, two.
One, go.
Go, go, go. Boom, lovely stuff. I think when it comes to like the little balls that you've got to shoot in his like zone, that's definitely a you thing. Cause my weapons are not suited to shoot those.
Straight up Rager Mark II kind of deal.
Yeah. Man, so much goes down in this tiny little arena.
I know.
It is crazy.
It really should have been a better boss fight. It really should have.
Think about this, right? This was the only Aether boss fight we got in BO4, like a proper boss fight, or the closest thing.
Because yeah. Alpha Omega really wasn't. It's the only boss fight area, I guess.
Hey, we're nearly done with these Brutuses. Just come on.
Like, pretty much everything apart from Zetsubou is better than this from BO3.
Yeah. Yeah. What's the best boss fight in your opinion ever? Now that we're like fully through into this video, that's a very fair point.
If we're doing Treyarch only.
Yeah, Treyarch only.
If it wasn't as easy as it is, I would say 9.
That's fair. I just think the sheer scale of it is kind of shocking.
If it was actually a challenge, 9 all the way.
Yeah. Okay.
Three, two, one. Go. Right, you can enter.
Oh, here we go. Oh, to enter the dark mechanism. Look at this, man. It's still crazy that this is a thing. Like, you're running around. Well, I've got a full cutscene going on.
You've got, like, a load of electrical shocks, like, hitting your body and stuff.
That was thanks to Brutus. Here we go.
Dude, when you spawn back in, it's going to be the quickest boss fight ever.
Oh, I know it is. I know. Look at Richtofen, man. I wish we could have seen more of this guy. Oh, Shiza.
I can't wait to see you.
Here we go. You ready to see me? I'm coming hot. Okay, here we go.
Here we go.
I'm raising the gates. I bring out my big crystal.
That is nuts.
Boom.
Done.
How was it that quick?
No, that's the final boss fight. After you've done that, that's supposed to be like, go ham. Takes 2 seconds.
Bro, I've never completed it that quick before.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
That is insane.
It's literally just where you land certain shots with the magma guy and it'll insta-kill him.
Wow, GGs. Okay, well now we've completed Blood of the Dead's boss fight, let's jump over to the DLC season, which starts with Dead of the Night. All right, everyone, Dead of the Night time. Hold square to proceed. You won't come back from this. Here we go. It's time to fight a massive werewolf. I've not done this in a hot minute, so I'm actually quite excited for this one. Here we go, there's the werewolf, and I swear since launch, he's always only had one glowing eye, and they've never fixed that. I don't know why. Or maybe, yeah, maybe he generally just has one eye, but okay, to start off this boss fight, we need to turn these slates until it's glowing on that little pad there. And also the werewolf is invisible right now, so that's always great. Always great. Okay, this one needs one more. Okay, now we just need to lead him into this little slab here. This boss fight is generally pretty simple. Like, this should be a walk in the park, especially right now. Sure, there he is. Okay, Jakey's got the Helion Salvo, so he can just go so ham sandwich on this guy. It's not even funny. We've got double homunculuses as well, so we could be able to take him down real quick. Okay, so we got to go ahead and move the screens, the statues for a second time. I do remember when this map first came out, you could use the steak knife and you could kill him in like 15 seconds, I think. It was something insane like that. So we train again. We go get, there he goes. There he goes. He's ready. Right, I'm going to chuck a homunculus. You can just go ham on him. Okay, here we go. This could be the easiest boss fight we've done yet. Bar 9. Honestly, the Helion Salvo makes any boss fight a joke. Okay, he's back for some more. All right, so we're not quite done yet. Almost ready. There we go. He's ready again. He's ready again. You know what? I'm going to chuck a Humunk. Come on, Mr. Werewolf. Here he is. There we go. Humunk's still down. Okay. All right, there we go. Easy. That's phase 1. And there we go. Another fresh set. Oh, so I think now we just get a bunch of vampires or just zombies and we get the other werewolves that are not quite as big as that one. They've definitely made his health a lot stronger than I remember. This is probably the calmest, like, mini bit before a boss coming back you'd ever have. That was very casual. And we got werewolves in now. I spoke too soon. All right, Hammer's going out. Hammer is going out. I swear, if Treyarch don't bring back something like the Helion in the next game, I will be so sad because you can't not have a gun that good. Okay, we got another set of max ammos and hammers.
We don't need to grab him at the moment. We're good. Okay, he is back in the map. He is back in the map. But we don't have the spot anymore, so I think we have to guess where it is. So we'll just keep turning. Okay, there we go. We've got the square. And I think... Oh, I'm red. Right behind it. There we go. There he is. Here we go. The final reckoning has begun. Okay, that clearly they've buffed him. Because before you could... With that, there's so much damage there that should have, like, taken him out. Okay, he's not taking any more damage. I think we've got one more. Here we go. Heard him howl just then. There he goes. This is going to be it. This is the one. Surely. There we go. Yep, we've done it. Trial by ordeal. This is my very first time doing the egg on PC. Hey, that was pretty good. You know what? I actually don't think this map deserves the hate it gets. It is pretty good. It's different, but in a good way. But now let's move on to what is easily the best Chaos map aside from 9, which is Ancient Evil. All right, my friends, we are here on Ancient Evil. Let's travel to the boss arena. You will not return. Here we go. Oh my God, it's been so long since I've done this boss fight. But I'm very, very excited for this. So we've got a Giganese that we've got to take out first. And then we can start hopping between islands, which I think is cool in itself. Oh, get away from me. That's him dead. All right. So now let's go ahead and hop to this island. Whee! Oh, we've got another one. Hello, where did you come from? Okay, where's Pegasus? Where's he at? All right. He's sweeping, but he's on the other side of the island. Yep, behind you. Here we go. Come on, Pegasus. Come on! All right, maybe. Yeah, he's down. Right, let's launch over. It's where Shack Rams are going to come in crazy handy. And the frames of the game just go crazy. Come on! All right, that's a decent amount done there. Okay, one island down. Just got to wait for Pegasus to come fly over again. Okay, final. He's coming behind me. Final phase. If you spam him like crazy, he might go down. Yep. Launching over. Okay. Standing some fire. Come on, Pegasus. Whoa. Okay, I think we're done. Let's get out. Get off the island. Woo-hoo-hoo. All right, and a max. Oh, that is unfortunate. Don't know what happened there. Okay, this should be it. Pegasus, you're going down, my friend. There he is. Just being so careful of this lightning. This should be the last one. Come on. Oh my God. Look at what I have to deal with, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, he's coming back. Here we go. Pegasus, there we go. All right, here we go. Come on. I think that's it. No more zombies. Pegasus is not flying anywhere. There we go. Worthless horse. Oh, it's so harsh. What did he ever do to you? Man, I forgot how cool this boss fight was. All right, he's just destroying everything now. Man, that looks so sick. Oh, I completely forgot. Yo, we can't even travel there anymore. This island only, my friends. I've got an insta-kill. Okay, we've got a Giganese. That's not what I want. Okay, he's going to teleport here any second now. Come on, my friend. Here we go. And he's here. Okay. Whirlwind activated. Here we go. Oh, he's put me in Dying Wish straight away. Okay. He's gone straight back to the middle. Oh, he's back. I've got mine as well. Here we go. Okay, not quite enough, but it's all right. Oh, he's back. Yep, he's back. Whoa! Okay, watch out, Jakey. Okay, he's back in. Here we go. There we go. Now we go ham sandwich. Okay, you got my attention. Come on, my dude. You can't take any more of this. I think we've done it. Ancient Evil, and there it is. The Oracle Key. Should we pick it up? I think we should pick it up. And there we have the ending of the Chaos story. And you know what? I thought this map was far better than any expectations had for it. And I really hope that we do see some sort of continuation for this. But anyway, on to the next boss fight, which is Alpha Omega and the Avogadro. Let's do it. Ladies and gentlemen, here we are. The boss fight for Alpha Omega, and technically the final boss fight in all of Call of Duty Zombies. Press square to activate APD release sequence. I'm pressing it. Jakey's pressed it. Here we go. So the first step is we've got to kill all these robots and fill up the canisters, moon style. I love that they've got that sort of throwback right at the start. What happened to my voice then? And you can kill them anywhere in the room. Oh, the canister is filled. Oh, what is coming out? Is it the avocado?
Do you really think you can contain
there the boy
me?
Is.
You only made me stronger.
I would have been fine with a stripper popping out of a cake, but not this.
Voice free verified.
Threat level midnight.
I love that threat level midnight. That's an Office reference. I can't believe they've done that in Zombies. Oh God, who remembers when this was first being solved and people thought this was literally gonna be like a nuke that would just wipe everyone and end the game, and people were like, what the heck? Before the boss fight's even begun, you're all gonna be wiped by the boss. Nuh-uh. I ain't scared of you, Mr. Avocado. I ain't scared of you, all right? Boom! I mean, you gotta admit, that looked amazing. Okay, now he's out. Oh, he's out, okay. Okay. Where are we going first? All right, we're going to go here. Okay, so our first portal call. Begin the soul capture. And the avocado is in here with us. And we've got to be careful with his electrical attacks, because if he does like a dash attack, like Sonic the Hedgehog, he like wipes you to like 25 health. And most of other attacks actually do a lot of damage. Got to be very careful. But in a way, this is not quite a boss fight because we don't actually fight him. We're just filling up soul canisters. So let me know what you guys think of this boss fight in the comments. Is it a yay, nay? Oh, he's loving Jakey right now. Absolutely loving him. Zombies are actually spawning in real slow considering. Oh, I'm electrocuted. Hey, there we go. First one down. All right, let's go. Now, these ones are definitely a lot more trickier just because you have so little space to really train around, and he's already in here. Oh, boy. Hey, look, there he is looking at me, putting 100 damage. How dare you, avocado? Zombies are dead slow in this. Yes, a fire sale and a boss fight. Hey, that's another one down. Right, can we get past them safely? Okay, there's the max ammo, and there's the... this one's also a little sketchy. It's because he either likes to be on this bottom shelf area here where I am, or up there where Jakey is. It's like a 50-50. You don't really know what the avocado is gonna do. Ooh, he's liking the look of Jakey right now. He's not even moving. Hello. And now he is. Oh, yep, I think we done. Yep. It's the final countdown. I can't sing anymore though, because YouTube don't like it. Legit, if I sang any more than that, it would genuinely get copyrighted. You can shoot the Avogadro, and it does temporarily stun him. Our boy is only weak to the ray gun. Oh, he's doing the dash attack. No, you don't. You're not Sonic the Hedgehog. Hey, there we go. All right. Oh, he's doing a dash attack as well. Oh my God. All right. The final bit of the final boss fight in Call of Duty Zombies is we need to shoot him or katana him into the front of the APD. Okay, he's in. Now, this step has always felt a little weird to me. It's because it just feels a little unnatural. Okay, can we do this in one take? Come on. Here we go. There we go. Boom, first try. Get sucked into that APD. My boy is gone. Okay, and now we can teleport him. And we're going to cause transit, which is great. There we go. Sent the lad straight to transit. It's mad. He's so mouthy in this map. Then in transit, he doesn't really say much, does he?
Rest easy, my friends. Avogadro is now safely contained in a Broken Arrow facility in Washington State. He's their problem now. We won, because that's what Americans do.
We win.
Man, Rushmore's so obnoxious.
You are now free to take the elemental shard. On behalf of the President of the United States, the Broken Arrow Program...
I love how he says on behalf of the President of the United States, like, he's really been holding this shard in this pyramid specifically. It's him that's controlling it. I'll try and see what happens if I can... Can I get inside the pyramid? Here we go. No. Boom, straight on the shard. So let's collect it. And there we go. The ending... Well, not quite the ending of Zombies, but the beginning of the end of Zombies, my friend. And that's going to wrap up all boss fights in Call of Duty Zombies. It has been quite the journey doing this all, getting all these Easter eggs done just for the boss fights. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you did, spare a second to drop a like rating, subscribe down below with the notifications turned on so you don't miss out on some more epic videos like this. You can find another video on screen right now. Drop me a follow on Twitter and Instagram if you want to keep up to date, and I'll catch you in another one very, very soon. Peace.